Our daily lives are affected by technology in innumerable ways.
We're all connected, we're all online, whether it's from our office, from our homes, and you know, we're either blogging, Twittering, or on a mobile device.
Our energy grid, our banking system, our healthcare delivery infrastructure.
This is an open network. It's our most important platform for free speech, for democratic participation, for the economy.
The real issue for users, however, is how do they stay safe online?
We have so much more complex cyber security concerns that we had in the past.
What we've seen is a very, very rapid growth in online fraud and online crime. More internet crimes are created every day by an order of magnitude than you see in the physical world in which we live.
Cybersecurity is a very important problem. It's not one of these problems that you can just solve right away. It really takes a concerted effort. It's a really great opportunity now for the new administration to put a stamp on doing something, making cybersecurity a national priority, and doing something very important and meaningful for the nation and for the world.
President Obama really has elevated cybersecurity as a major priority for his administration.
The frame is public-private partnership. It's collaboration between all the entities with a stake in the medium. We think that's the right approach.
So it's really got to be this academia, industry, government ecosystem, this partnership, all working together to make cyberspace more secure.
At the federal government level, we have many, many roles, and we have many departments that are involved. It's the Department of Homeland Security, the Department of Defense, the Department of Commerce, the Department of State, just to name a few, the Department of Justice. But it's the protection of security, it's the protection of the integrity of infrastructure, the governmental infrastructure that we have, both .gov and .mil.
State and local governments were involved in the 60-day review based on the fact that we run a multi-state information sharing and analysis center. We brought together the executive committee from the multi-state ISAC to sit down and talk about the issues that state and local governments in U.S. territories have, both from the challenges that we face, the areas of need for improvement.
And then there's the academic community that has actually been doing research in security for decades. They certainly have a voice to be heard. The kind of research that the academic community does is fundamental, unclassified, long-term research, the very kind of research that you want in any kind of national strategy for cybersecurity.
With more than 80 or 85% of the infrastructure owned by the private sector, we nor the government can secure it without appropriate and thoughtful collaboration.
One of our key areas is to work with the private sector to make sure that they are acting to protect themselves, and that there's a constant and ongoing communication between the government or those of us in the federal government and those in the private sector, particularly where we're concerned with the protection of our infrastructure.
There are areas of investment that the government could make that would certainly enhance the long-term viability of the technologies that are necessary to protect the next generation, if you will, of users online.
There's always issues relative to privacy when you're talking about cybersecurity.
One of the things that we were particularly pleased about in this review is both how transparent and how open the process was. The leadership team for the cybersecurity review was very, very open and reached out to my group and to other groups that care about privacy and civil liberties on the internet. You know, I will say it's the first time in a long time that we've been invited to give our input, and we're very pleased. We think our suggestions are reflected in the final report.
I don't know that the term cybersecurity means much to John Q. Public walking down the street. I do think, though, more and more American homes do operate online. And I think they have a basic understanding of what a virus is or what a worm is, or they clearly know what spam is. But I think more could be done.
Cybersecurity is a very important problem. It's not one of these problems that you can just solve right away. It really takes a concerted effort. It takes attention at the highest level to make sure that all the different parties who are interested in cybersecurity are coordinated, that we're all on the same page, that we're all striving for the same goals.
It's all our jobs, and if we're going to be secure, it's got to be everyone's responsibility.
This is the next great area of security for our country, and it's so very important that we all get at it.